Hello, ladies and gentlemen. This is Mars coming at you with another StarCraft 2 cast. This is the IEM Katowice. I'm going to call this the World Championship from now on because I actually have no fucking clue how you're supposed to pronounce Katowice. So, IEM Katowice, this is from the open bracket number one. There's one reason and one reason only that I'm casting this. It's because this happened when I was at work, so I didn't see these games. And I suppose I could go back into like the official IEM YouTube and look at them. Other than that, I suppose I could cast my own damn self. So here you go. Big shout out to everybody at IEM for putting on like the World Championship. And yeah, releasing the replay so that people can learn from them. And I must wait. Am I allowed to cast this? I'm allowed to cast this, right? I don't know. I'm seeing other people casting this, like, fuck, sure, I'll do that. Anyway! spawning in the bottom right position. Hailing from the cold and low country of the Netherlands. It is Harstem. His opponent! Judging from the slightly higher country, little bit to the east, it's Lambo. Wait, Lambo is German, right? I should know this. Lambo, are you German? Lambo is German. Yes, I'm looking at the brackets right now. Lambo is German. Alright, so let's get into this cast. We've got a fairly standard opening on both sides. Well, this is a Nexus first. This is the most standard thing, and Lambo doesn't have a fucking clue. So it's not the most standard opening from Harstem, but Lambo's pretty normal. So we've got a hatch first, then we got a pool, we got some speed, we've got queens on the way, and Harstem sees all of it. Lambo, on the other hand, sees that his opponent has walled off down here. Where is the Simon Editor? There you go. It's a two-gate sort of thing. But this is a big ramp, so this is hard. If Lambo had gone for like a speedling all-in, he would have been feeling good right about now. He's going to have time to wall that off if he so chooses. Oh, it doesn't even choose to chase it. All right. But doesn't know about the Nexus, although should, perfectly honest, be able to guess as much. Oh dear, and these are players that are actually well known, so I can like provide you details about them. Normally I just, you know, cast random people on the internet, so this is very exciting. Harstem, who is of course a major tournament winner. Wait, was that a premier event? Was that a major event? Alright, I guess I'm not as well informed as I thought. Has won major events in the past, and even more important, oh, preemptive warping back there from Harstem. Home Story Cup winner. So that's pretty much the highest honor you can get as a player, as a StarCraft 2 player. Lambo, on the other hand, hasn't won any major tournaments unless by chance he has won the Meisterschaft. ESL, whatchamacallit. Alright. So, we've got a little bit of action going on here. We've got Zerglings being built by Lambo and Harstem not shading in, just doing a little bit of scouting, keeping his three adepts occupied, and to be perfectly honest, he hasn't gotten even close enough to scout this third base, so doesn't know that much. He wants to make sure that he isn't caught out in the middle, surrounded by a bunch of Zerglings, and then horribly murdered by the Banelings that roll in afterwards. It does have the resonating glaives coming in, going to get a robotics facility, probably for some warping in on location, or possibly some immortals, although I'm guessing that comes later. Lambo sees all of this, may wonder if there is a dark shrine building here or there, but there isn't, so he's quite Taking that third, and that does get scouted. Lambo sees that, but with three zergling, he doesn't have enough to deal with it. What he should be worried about, and what he knows is there, is a small army of adepts on his front lawn. And what is there to deal with that? Well, zerglings and you finish that. No, that doesn't look like a good thing. Adepts, of course, don't see nearly as much as they used to, but they definitely saw that they were surrounded by Zerglings and Banelings, and that if they were to finish that shade in, terrible, terrible things would happen to them. I like this one. This Adept doing the job of a cannon. Even going to get built in, if he's not paying attention. Harstem going to try and do a little bit of droppage right there. If he keeps on his current path, it's going to be well spotted, but this is completely free if it's your chooses. So, Lambo and Harstem, both very accomplished players, and both forces to rear. Oh, I believe that's not going to get scouted. That is not going to get scouted. Just about to get scouted here, but should be able to get a one or two probes right there. That's two probes, three probes, and a pickup with no damage dealt with. Actually, no damage. What? You had to ruin that for me, didn't you? You had to ruin that for me. Got one hit in. That was more than just a paint job. So we have actually lost actual damage. Lambo taking a fourth in reaction to a third of Harstem. Both have fully saturated pretty much, at least their three working bases. This one's fully saturated. This one's fully saturated. This is fully saturated. This is fully saturated. This is fully saturated. And Lambo is quite comfortable in taking this to the late game. Not intended to, you know, pushing is not aggressive. Is comfortable in just receiving the attacks of Harstem, pushing them back, building up his forces and striking back. But here comes one of those attacks I was talking about. So let's see what Harstem can do. We've got 58 army to 63. We've got a very nice position for the Protoss with lots of force fields to spare. A natural force field in of that hatchery. And there we go. None of the Banelings. Actually, all of the Banelings do come in. One of the force loops does get broken, and a lot of the adepts go down there, but there's still enough there. There's the next bunch of Banelings, though. Can he do the same thing? Oh, well, that is exactly what Harstem came for. He wanted to kill that geyser. That geyser. Fuck that geyser, man. Also took out 9 workers, it must be said. Alright, let's see if we pulled all the Zerglings. Yes, we did, but there is enough here in position. Oh, that should be going down. There you go. Gets another 4 kills, and the rest of the army with the very powerful and very expensive and taking very long bloody time to build units, still intact. Or at least, nope. Just lost 3 sentries. And those adepts, those 16 adepts, yes, that did stop the attack, but it's also the easiest thing for Harstem to replace. So Lambo held that off, but didn't in any way cripple Harstem. He should still be expecting shit to go down fairly soon. Folks in there once again. And Lambo doesn't know about this fourth base. Hasn't saturated this, and what is this? Ah, 2 adepts going by. Harstem doesn't know about this base either, but should suspect as much. Alright, and here we go. Harstem going to be on the receiving end this time. How much army supply is there? 94 Zerg army supply. And this should be a couple of free warp gates if he so chooses. Oh! Very nicely gets out of range of that overcharge. More Banelings coming on in there, and going to take out. There you go. Just enough there, and loses one Ravager for it. Harstem not sending in those Adepts. Oh, look at that. Oh, is Storm done? Is Storm done? Storm is done! Storm is done, and those are nice Storms. Those are nice Storms. Does get all those Banelings, and now Lambo will have to rethink his plan of attack, although that is certainly a very nice thing. Those are expensive, and there come the Adepts. There is a Queen there to defend, so he should be able to hold off a little bit of it, but if Harstem focuses this down, as he does, he should be able to kill all the forces there. Once again into the base over here, this time it is Lambo making sure that there's no force fields for him, but there is enough SimCity here to make sure that Harstem has a hard time of this. This adept only took out four workers. So did shift click a little bit, but didn't really do it. There he goes once again, the overcharge, and all those Zerglings and Banelings coming on in there on the Stalkers. And lots of Ravagers unloading as well. Harstem, nope. Blinks out of there, and most of the cannon fodder for Lambo has been taken out. Lots of Ravagers still there. Oops, does get a little bit of damage on the Mandatory Core, but all the Zerglings are gone. All the Zerglings are gone. That means that these Ravagers aren't the greatest thing, especially because Lambo's got the melee attack and not the range attack. So the Corrosive Bile do a lot of damage, and there go a bunch of Banelings. Should have saved these off, and now we've got the Zerglings streaming on in there. Those Corrosive Biles pushing Harstem on back there, but what is this? I was expecting the Dark Shrines, because the Dark Shrine finished and there's no detection here for Lambo. Lambo getting pushed back there though with non-invisible Protoss bullshit units, which is of course very impressive. This in the meantime is completely uncontested, whereas Lambo here lost a queen. So Lambo keeping up with the aggression, even going to send four Zerglings on by, but oh, there's a couple more. There is that DT, but with two cannons there, that's not going to go very well. All right, cool. Here's the DT, and how much? Oh, he does know. He does know. Did he see something move, or did he skip? I don't even know where the DT shrine is. Where is the DT shrine? Doesn't know about it. Hasn't seen it, but is moving stuff into position. Saw that walking on by. Does know what it is. Very nicely seen by Lambo there. And is this done? There you go. Oh! No! Oh, that is unfortunate. There's another one here. Have you built any of those portable detection things yet? Yeah, there you go. All right. I'm going to get the pneumatized carapace, and he does. Good. He should be able to hunt down those DTs. Now, at the back of all of this, I'd like to mention that Harstem's got 84 workers. That is a lot of workers. That is a lot of income. Lambo a little bit on a more traditional 60, which is a little bit low, but does allow for more army supply, or at least it would be the case if we were maxed out. At 166 to 162, he does actually have a bigger army by quite a bit, but if he loses his army, is going to be harder to replace. What is this? And here we go, going in from Adept to Zealots. No charge yet. Was there no charge? There was no charge. Alright. Does lose one of them. Zealots very, very strong in the late game. But, you know, when they have charge. And charge not on the way. Then again. Charge. Very good. Excellent. Totally, totally great update. You know what the charge is not good against? These guys. How do I get? Can I just select all of them? There you go. There are seven of them. There are currently 12 more being made. And things that automatically charge to their death. Not the greatest units in the world. So, yeah. A charge lot, very good. But against Banelings, not fantastic. Alright, we got Lambo coming around there for a full surround. Look at that. There comes a storm. There comes yet more storm. And that's all there is. Storms with Corrosive Bolt raining on down there. And... What? Am I missing something? Yes, I am. I am missing many things. This is what I'm missing. There's another one here. So his main base was about to be taken out. He was about... And Yeah, a lot of this was still alive as well. Harstem ahead in the army supply with 1, 2, 3 mining bases in the back of it. I'm assuming this one is empty. Whereas he himself has nothing here, has nothing there. He's only got 54 workers. So, GG! Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to the IEM Open Bracket Qualification Thingamabob. This is why they have professional casters, because they are then able to tell you that this is in Poland, in Katowice, or however that's pronounced, and in what part of the bracket this is. This is actually the, let me see, this is a qualifying match. This is the qualifying match between Harstem and Lambo, and this guy is up 1-0. He's Dutch. He's called Kevin. It's Harstem. His opponent is German. His mother gave him a name, but then he said, screw it, I want to be known as Lambo. Wait, wasn't this, didn't he used to be Lambo King? I don't know. I'll have to look that up. All right, in the previous match on Newkirk Precinct, we saw Harstem macroing up and poking a little bit. Whereas Lambo decided to just receive Harstem and just defend and then in the end push back. Didn't manage to... Ooh, did he just deny the spawning pool? That's a nice little trick there. In the end, didn't get this damage done, and Harstem went on to eventually win numerically, upgradingly, and army compositionally. That's definitely a word. This game on Abyssal Reef. Let's see if Lambo can do any better. We've got the hatch first. We've got a gateway before Nexus this time, which is different from Harstem. And I can't really blame him, because the rush distance here isn't the longest in the game. It's not the shortest, but you can get some Zerglings in your opponent's base fairly quickly. So Harstem just making sure that he's got a gateway able to make, you know, a zealot or whatever to back this up. Doesn't need to do that. Did get that early scout off, and is just going to get an adept and that mothership core. Harstem used to play very fast and loose with the mothership core, but he's not going to do so much this time. Gets that mothership core right away. Does mean that he's going to be a little bit later with his chosen tech, but then again, he's facing off against Zerg, and more specifically Lambo. Last game, he stayed on that hatchery tech very long. Oh, denying that third base. Going down for a little bit, but the Zerglings do make sure that that eventually does go down. All right, and Harstem is going. Let's go take a walk with the mothership core, shall we? Look around. Look at all the little fishies. This is actually, this map is very different when I cast and from when I play, because all of this is high detail, which is great if you're casting. We got a pylon rush. That's what happens if you try to take in the view. And Lambo, what does he have to deal with it? He's building four drones. Four drones is not great, but he can just still cancel this hatchery though. This hatchery can still be canceled. Because right now he's building 8 Zerglings, and that's not great. Oh, 2 queens on the way to the rescue, but it's not going to be on time. And it does get cancelled. The drone gets away. Alright, excellent. Nope, never mind. I spoke too soon. The tourist of the mothership core is going to get that. And Lambo very wisely puts down that third base over here. But Harstem did get a little bit of a delay in. Lambo sees everything, sees that gateway, which is unfortunate because there's actually tech here you may want to see. Our pylon is under attack. There goes that pylon. This map, best place to take a third, a little bit contested. A lot of people take it here. Also, a lot of people take it here. It depends very much on the matchup. If you're going to face off against, say, Terrence, who can put tanks here, I don't recommend this as a third base. I do not recommend it at all. But, you know, in any other in many other matchups, including this one, it is quite a viable. Alright, Harstem getting his third as well. And has he scouted that? Oh yes, he has, because there is an overlord right there, so he sees everything. I don't know what I'm concerned about. Did also see those adepts leave the base and in place to deal with it. He's got Zerglings and Banelings, and Harstem sees all of this. Yeah, and does cancel. Adept's not the best of dealing a lot of damage to buildings, so decides not to try and push that in. And Lambo does scout that. There's the first thing that actually shoots up, and Lambo is driven slash tickled away. Away, little overlords. He's actually going to go down. Oh. Lambo just making sure no shenanigans does happen. That overlord, it did actually die. Alright, cool. And this overlord is going to die. So Lambo did see a lot of things for a long time, but now he should... No, he's not supply blocked. He's fine. He got lots of overlord, and that may just mean he is ready to start pumping out those army units, getting ready to receive the aggression by Harstem. And Harstem once again going for that drop play early on, but with Zerglings and good creep shred, Harstem should be Lambo should be just fine. Now on the maximum like zoom level, which I don't have. Oh yes, yes I do. Wait, where are you? There you go. Hello, shark. I thought you had to do like the maximum zoom back level. Oh, here we go. Does get a couple of adepts in there. Is going to focus down two, three workers. And is going to get driven up. And maybe four, six, well, seven. Seven at the cost of one adept. That is worth it right there. I thought he was maybe thinking about just abandoning these to their fate. But nope. He does not. Those guys do have the resonating glaives. This is what's annoying about this map, by the way. These guys can just stay here forever. There's nothing you can do with it until you get that spire to deal with it. And Lambo is not going for a spire. Lambo is going for a Hydralisk den, or more specifically, a Lurker den. Very strong against Protoss if you can bring them to bear. Because right now, Harstem is poking in a little bit with a Death Shade. There is more things warping in right there. But the Zerglings have one, or just one attack right now. That means that they are quite a bit better. I don't know what died here. I hope not a lot for Lambo. And I hope not for you either, because you're here to view all the action, and none of the cameras were trained on it. So if nothing happened there, then you didn't miss shit. Alright, that that plus one attack does make these a little bit better to deal with this. Although, putting in a spore crawler might be useful as well. Just to make sure that this can't just idle over that indefinitely. Fourth hatchery going down, almost done even. And Harstem, not to be outdone, puts out a fourth nexus. I believe I was saying something about different graphical fidelities, because this annoys the ever-living crap out of me when I play. Like, you gotta turn this loose, because every time you focus on, like, if you're watching this and there's something flitting around in your vision here, I'm assuming it's a ling drop, or like I don't know, and I panic and I take my army there to look at fish. Great map, by the way. Absolutely fantastic, but don't play it on high settings. Alright, so what does Harstem have to deal with the lurkers? Well, he's got Storm. Storm, not horrible against it. You can just, you know, fire it and forget, so you don't have to worry about that. Harstem is going to get that scout off. And these guys are going to go the other way. Right, going for a little bit of two-pronged attack right there. Oh, he's trying to make sure Harstem stays over here, where the main push goes over there. This is not scouted by Harstem. And what is Harstem going to do about that amount of lurkers right on his front doors? Because there's nothing he has to really deal with it. And we have a run by over here. Oh, Harstem, he does have vision. Oh, that is a very nice storm right there. Does take out the thing. And in the meantime, his entire front of his base, his breached Britain, not there anymore. And he's got his lurkers in such a fantastic position. This building working very much against him. You should wait till those lurkers take it out, because these, you can only come in two or three abreast. Look at that, 32 workers already being taken down. Two or three abreast, his main army is standing out here. Can't really do anything without walking through a field of death. There we go, coming on in there. He's going to take out the lurkers. Nope, going to commit and going to lose an immortal to this as well. In the meantime, there go your things in the main base. Oh, that is a very nice storm. Didn't kill so much, and all the lurkers are still there. Thankfully, these aren't roaches. They don't actually regenerate when they're there, but holy shit, Harstem ever in a load of trouble. Lambo just coming in there with nothing but units, just building units after unit. Oh, that's very nice. And he's got the main base completely isolated from everything that's going on over here. Harstem going on in there. Lambo even going on in there, but it doesn't even matter. Lambo pushes his way to victory with the lurkers, and GG. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. This is the IEM qualifying brackets. This is game three, Harstem versus Lambo. The winner qualifies to the main tournament of this IEM World Championship, taking place in Katowice in the past, because these are replays. The IEM World Championship happened 2 weeks ago, and they're not having me as a full live caster, because they're having professionals doing this. Game one, we saw Harstem and Lambo slowly build up their forces, and eventually coming to a number of small clashes. Eventually, Harstem... Lambo trying to push his way through to Harstem's third, but failing, and eventually Harstem kicking the front door in of Lambo. That's not actually true. Lambo pushed in, lost most of his army, didn't have enough of an economy at the back of it. There were a bunch of DTs in his base, and he GG'd out. Second game, on the other hand, Lambo went for a lurker push, and he got a fantastic position. Now we're in Bel'Shir Vestige, or Vestige, or I don't know, Bel'Shir? I don't know. Like, I know humans pronounce it as Bel'Shir, but I wonder how the Protoss would actually pronounce it. Probably similarly, and if not, then too fucking bad, because I don't speak Protoss. Whatever language it is they do. So... we've got a hatchery coming on down here with a spawning pool in the back, which is a normal opening. We had a gateway first with a nexus follow-up, which is also fairly common. Harstem, once again, feeling comfortable walling off the big ramp, or opening in this case, because as it is not a ramp at front of his base. Lambo not the type to rush. And this is the second time where he scouted his opponent's base, where he got like, maybe I should have rushed. Because if you get 8 Zerglings here, right now, which is possible, then you can do a lot of damage. You take out this, and it's GG. Instead, we're going to try, Lambo's going to try and take that third base. He is going to succeed, because he did... shoot that away. So, once again, settling in for a little bit of a longer game. Once again, the Twilight Council. Once again, the Robo Facility. This is pretty much the same builder he had the first two games. And Lambo not doing anything out of the ordinary either. So, yeah, what's going to go on? Lambo just making sure that that wall is still open. Maybe he's thinking about building those 8 Zerglings now. Nope, there comes the wall. Is that a wall? Is that one hex? That is one hex. That is correct. All right, cool. Harstem, of course, far better protos than I am, probably knows what he's... Hey, wait a minute. That's not what we saw in the first two games. In the first two games, we saw resonating glaives. This time, not so much. Lambo scouts that and is not going to be caught with his pants down. But if you were a Zerg, this can still really, well, catch you with your pants down. You gotta have those spore crawlers in place, or you gotta have that floating detection. Preferably, you want two of them because you don't specifically know. You don't know where that warp prism is going to. That warp prism can show up here. That warp prism can show up there. And it is very nice that Lambo's just making sure. Oh, well, that actually probably told the tale. And should be able to now just follow that. Or not. And he knows he's going to get four DTs warped in. Some players go for the Archon right away. But you might as well just... Oh, he's only going for two. Only going to go for two. Only has money for two. And two queens and a bunch of zerglings should be able to do that. So gets a... I don't know if those are two half zerglings. I think those are two half zerglings. So he lost two zerglings. He lost three. Maybe lost one earlier somewhere else. And that is staved off. May decide to combine these into an Archon now. Back of this, though, got that third, which is unscouted. I don't know how much Lambo was paying attention. Should have seen that. Because you see this guy moving on out there. Look, there you go. So you should be able to see that. There is the first Archon, the second Archon combat on in there. And Archons, of course, do extra damage versus organic. Is that organic? Wait, is that correct? What do you call it? Biological, excuse me. And all of this is biological. Oh, gets the queen in position, gets a little bit of a pot shot, make sure that that warp prism is forced to get on out of there, because that's really the best defense you have against this play. Making sure that your opponent feels uncomfortable staying there with a warp prism, because at any point you can just pick up those Archons and regenerate those shields, and you have to start all the way from the start. Nice scouting by Lambo, though. Retakes that Zelnaga tower. Is going to lose an overseer, but that is alright. So, 60 workers to 53. Lambo feels comfortable enough to keep droning at the back of this. Does have his poach, now has a couple of roaches. Should feel just fine. I don't know where his defending queens went. Where are those defending queens? There they are. Alright, just making sure nothing gets on in there. And now we're going to push down here once again. And how much is there to defend him? Quite a lot, as a matter of fact. But the Ravagers aren't finished in warping in just yet. And, oh, gets a couple of free shots pretty much, as there's not yet enough to defend that. But here we go. We got the engagement right here. We got a nice concave for Lambo. But it does make, Harstem does make sure he dodges those corrosive bowels. And, this is a lot of Protoss. Lambo? Alright, Lambo pulling those drones, pulling the drones and prones against, Adepts, even with their upgrade, which is called something or other, resonating glaives. That is not a fantastic trade. Loses 18 of the drones, and still there is more army here for Harstem as there is for his opponent, including an immortal. And those immortals do, of course, do such a great amount of damage versus these guys right here. Does make sure that his natural middle line doesn't get gutted, but that third base, not looking good. And even if Lambo were to go in right now, he can't save that. This is, of course, his qualifying match right now. Lambo doesn't want to get out of there, but as a two-base Zerg against a three-base Protoss. Oh, it's probably for the best. He doesn't know this. Oh shit. Oh, here we go. Lambo gunning on in there. It's like, how saturated is this? Oh, this is really saturated, you say. Oh shit. So Lambo on the ropes. Lambo's going to have to retake this. And he doesn't have enough army there to do great amount of damage. 62 to 62. If you were to counter push right now, well, most importantly, Harstem can just backstab him. That's fine. He's got the army to defend that and to defend this push, and then he can just warp in and wreck his opponent's mineral line. Oh, yeah. No. Oh, there we go. Let's see what happens. There is that income graph, just to make sure that you know what I'm talking about. This is what's keeping Lambo back here. Oh, and a fourth base going on down there, adding insult to injury. Oh, he doesn't even have his own third base yet. All right. Oh, I want to say all of his workers are still there, but he did lose 20 of them. There's 46 workers, 73. That is a great deal more income, as you can see right here, for the Dutch Protoss. And, well, this worked last time. This worked last time. Let's see if we can do it again. All right, Lambo moving on out there with 8 lurkers. And if he can get the position, then he can still salvage that. Lurkers, there are a couple of things on the army by Harstem that really deal okay with these. But if you can get these in position as he morphs in, no, those are Ravagers. That's not another thing. Oh, now it's going to cancel this fourth base at least. There you go. And what do we have over here? Well, 2 adepts making sure that that doesn't happen. And here is that warping. Here is that backstep I was talking about. Yes, he does cancel that third. Kills the things right there. And GG. Main base was free to warp in. This was denied mining, and he just burrowed a bunch of lurkers. I think he just lost a couple. He just lost 4 of them. And there are 2 disruptors at the top, very much ready to deal with it. Harstem moves on down to the group stage. Congratulations. GG. If you enjoyed this video, press that like button. If you'd like to see more of me, subscribe.